Breathe deep and move.
If there's fighting, you run, and you do not stop for anything.
Always room for more? What's hiding here? What's in here?
Whatever's in the air, it tastes foul.
Could chomp me in two.
slender drow blade impales the stone before you, keeping a silent vigil. This blade was a warrior's sacrifice to Elis Stray. Blood can only be honored with blood. The drow script inscribed on the blade flickers and glows. It rises from the stone, hanging in the air in silent offering.
Should mind my step. Best be on my way.
More are coming.
What in the nine hells is that?
They're coming. They're coming.
No, something's coming. And if it lives down here in the dark, it won't be anything good.
They are coming. You are coming.
Still alive, so that's progress. Very well.
A better position. Leave no trace.
Where do I go from here?
Make way.
This is my happy place. Heading out.
Is gonna fall.
Thank you.
ready. Might be useful. Broken bones.
Battle has taken its toll. I should rest.
Anything of use? Be wary. Better than nothing.
Over there. What's in here? Skeleton key. The Black Network's mark. Spies, murderers, and thieves ahead, I guess.
Hotfoot, place is trapped.
move. Don't waste a step.
Enough waiting. I crave blood. Repositioning.
Someone there?
No time to rest. On my way.
Chimisks, known to cause confusion. Best not to get too close.
Stopped me yet. Can't give up now. Moving in.
Damask and torch stalks. Hell of a combination. I'm confused again. Blown up by the other.
What to do? Time to press ahead. Maybe I need more pockets. No traps, please.
Corpses. These creatures did battle with Dwergar.
Looks abandoned.
was swallowed by a chorus of turbulent music. Through one creature sing many voices, the harmony of an entire collective.
Sovereign, he has come. He is here.
The choir fades. A single melody rises above the others, brassy and commanding.
I am sovereign.
You see a vision. Your lifeless body wrapped in fungal tendrils. The sovereign is threatening you.
State your purpose.
Fungal roots weave through your mind, seeking your true intent. Then the sovereign drones a new melody, cautious but welcoming.
Descend to me. Let us speak in flesh.
The persistent music coaxes you forward. The sovereign expects you.
Smell a trap.
What? Gek! Got someone sneaking up on us! What's this? Got ourselves an infiltrator. You move pretty quietly. Not quietly enough for my liking, though. Noise gets you eaten down here. Reckon I'll hush you. Before something hungry comes along.
His gnarled fist grips an axe.
Fine. I'll let you live. But spoil my hunt, and you're dead. Share? You really are in the wrong place, son scum. Try this for useful. Falling down a deep, dark hole is the kindest death you'll find in the Underdark. Told you. Hunting. Slave ran away. Took Sergeant Thryn's boots. Gotta kill the slave and fetch back the leather. Or the bosses in Moonrise will have Thryn's hide. Sergeant told me to. Besides, we're talking about a slave. A bleeding heart, are you? Reckon I'll just roast and eat it.
Let's try this.
Thank you.
go. Breathe deep and move.
Got it. move.
Nothing will stand in my way. What's inside? I bet that'll fit in my pack. Very well.
Ah, a visitor. You're a welcome sight. But let us observe the customs of the locals.
The scholar's brow tenses. His voice spills into your skull, the spores connecting mind to mind.
Blurg, proud member of the Society of Brilliance, at your service. Or perhaps not. Your mind is far more complex than that of the fungi. Understandable. We are small in number and rarely stay in one place for long. My colleagues and I are working to improve conditions in the Underdark. This need not be such a dire, hostile place. It's curious to find a surface dweller here. What has brought you down so deep? Truly remarkable. But why come to the Underdark, where they hold so much power? You were infected by an illithid tadpole? It's a miracle you're still intact. You must be worried sick, but have no fear. I have a friend who may be able to assist. Omelium!
I hope this is important, Blurg. My Zirkwood samples need constant attention.
It is. This adventurer has an illithid tadpole inside his head, but he hasn't turned.
No ceramorphosis? That's impossible, but intriguing. Are you looking to have it extracted?
Geich, your head will make a fine trophy for my queen.
Please hold. I understand your rage against my kin. One of my brethren forced a tadpole into your eye. Or ear, perhaps? But I assure you, I stand with the Society of Brilliance, not the colonies of my people.
Fool! They infest your head and invade your dreams, and still you would parley.
I ask only that you refrain from violence. I respect that your opinion of my kind may be charged. If that settles matters for the time being, would you like a diagnosis? Open your mind to me. Let us see what lurks within.
As the Meloan's mind pierces yours, the tadpole pulses with power. It feels 10 times its size, alive, awake, almost smug.
This is most unusual. The incubation period should be complete, as should your transformation. But the larva is infused with strange magic. It appears to be in some form of stasis. No, it appears to be shielded from physical and magical influence. And even without the shield, the extraction would involve severe cranial trauma. It is not ideal. The process would surely kill you. But not to worry. Should you transform, I will happily perform a new examination. A Nautiloid? Fascinating. I have never set foot on one myself. They were our warships during the greatest eras of the Illithid Empire. We ruled the entire astral plane from their decks. The design was lost when the Gith rebelled and ended our dominion. Of course. I am sorry I cannot assist you in this. But I have an idea.
Oh, perhaps I should start taking notes.
There may be a way to bypass that stasis. There are many alchemical substances that can influence the mind. A tincture distilled from a collection of rare mushrooms. They have subtle psionic influence. I would require a fresh ton of madness and Timusk spores. But be warned, in their natural state, both of these mushrooms can be quite dangerous. Timusks cause confusion in those that approach them. The tongue is self-explanatory.
The Underdark, of course, although they are quite rare, and their discovery perilous. I imagine Lenore would have them in her possession. She served Mistra as a cleric. The southwest when I last saw her, although her tower does have a tendency to move. She is quite fond of her garden. Lenore has always been a lonely sort. Nature was her only companion. I offered her the chance to join the society, but she refused. Her experiments on Sousa bark took priority.
My formula will hamper the more harmful effects once the mushrooms are brewed into a potion. Your sanity, however much you possess, should remain intact. May your travels be safe and swift.
Welcome back. Have you made any new discoveries? The feeling is mutual, friend. I have only passing familiarity with the surface races. But I found that there is as much to learn from an individual as there is from a community. So it is with the Myconids. They live in harmonious unity, but each has a unique personality. Yes, but it has abundant natural resources. Spores, water orbs, Trillimac. I've studied them for years.
There is rare magic in the Underdark too. Fairsras. It radiates from the earth, warping, teleportation, and divination magic.
Exactly. It's such a relief to meet another sensible mind. I do enjoy a good bargain, if anything in my private collection is to your liking.